Hi, welcome to my next video. This time I wanted to show you the next picture that I did with the tools that I received from Kuretake, which is a Japanese art supplies maker. Amongst the tools that they sent for me to try during the World Watercolor Month was a small 12 color set of watercolors. I thought that this tool would be great to do a simple sketch, and either way I wanted to paint something less complicated and less involved than the previous pictures that I did recently, so I settled on a nice car. Few years ago, when we still lived outside of Tokyo near Enoshima, we lived relatively close to a place that specialized in fixing European kind of retro and old cars. So almost every time we went to just do our regular shopping at the supermarket, I would be very excited to just go past this place and see what new cars were just parked outside it. If I saw something that piqued my interest, I would take many photos. And also the whole neighborhood was a bit of a beach culture kind of place, with a lot of people who liked retro things, so you would actually see some cool retro cars just there on the streets also. So throughout our stay there, I was able to gather some really good reference material. This time I also opened the reference folder and picked this cool looking Renault 4, I think. I really like the design of this car and the color of this car. I like the bumpers and the lights and the weird protruding things that it has on the bumpers and in front, like these pipes, and of course the folding roof. I was really happy to see all the comments that poured in when I posted this picture to Instagram. A lot of you commented that your family actually had this car, or you remembered someone having this car from your childhood, so it was a really nostalgic car for you. I was very happy to hear all the memories from your comments and messages. After doing a few simple preparatory sketches in my sketchbook, I did the final pencil lines on a thicker mixed media paper in my Fabriano Venice sketchbook. I have been using this sketchbook a lot lately for less involved, more kind of sketchy pictures, especially ones that I want to do with lines and with less heavy watercolors. It's a very good sketchbook with good quality paper. I had not have any problems with it so far. The only thing is that it's kind of thick and heavy and it doesn't open all the way, so it's difficult to scan the pieces once they are done. But the Fabriano paper works well with a lot of things that I tried on it so far. It's not exactly a textured watercolor paper, so it's not very good for heavy watercolors, but it fares well with a lot of pens and all kinds of weird things. And for example, works well also with fineliners, so what I'm using here. I got from Kuretake the whole set of the Mangaka fineliners, which consists of 6 pens that are just your regular fineliners with fine tips like 0.03 and so on, but also has 2 thicker pens with these kind of oblong tips, which allow you to do more ink brush style lines. This seems like a very solid pen set, not only for someone who wants to do illustrations in black and white manga style, but also who wants to combine these with watercolors, because all of these pens are waterproof and quite lightfast from what I've been told. Then again, most of the felt tipped fine liners that you can buy have these qualities, so you should probably choose the ones that you can buy at your place and the ones that you like. Don't think there's so much difference in the quality of the line. Anyway, when the line work was complete, I erased the pencil underdrawing and started coloring the thing with the 12 color transparent watercolor set. And this is something different than the Gansai Tambi watercolors that I already tried and made a video here on this channel. These are just your standard transparent watercolors, so a product probably very similar in formulation to other Western style watercolor brands. The set that I received has 12 colors including white and comes in like a plastic tray, which is closed in a plastic box that's really similar in shape and size to a floppy disk box, if you know what I mean, if anyone still uses these. In this tray there are indentations for each color, and there's just a bit of paint of each color in each indentation. So I think this is just like a demo set of these watercolors, and from what I have seen on the Kuretake website, they have a bit better plastic box and brush set there also. So I think this is like a demo set with 2 blues, 2 greens, 2 reds, violet, black, yellow, some earth colors, and the white. From what I have been told, these are also scale 4, blue wool scale, light fast, so they could be used in a more professional manner, and I had no problems with painting with them here, just as I would do with any other brands of watercolors that I usually use. I didn't have this fun and novelty feeling as I did when using the Gansai Tambi set, which is different than your standard Western watercolor. So there's something new, there's something interesting and exciting about using them because they behave a bit different and have different formulation. But here I just got this feeling that these are just standard, not really the highest but not really low quality either, watercolors that any other probably brand of good quality watercolors will do as good as these. So sadly I don't have anything exciting to report about these watercolors. They just worked fine and were just watercolors. But I have a thing that I want to complain a bit, and it's the whole set as a thing that I received. Package is really flimsy, the box is really flimsy. As I said, it reminds me of a floppy disk case that was just repurposed to house some watercolors. The plastic box itself is flimsy and the plastic tray in which the watercolors sit is also flimsy, so it's not a pleasurable experience to use this set. Maybe if Kuretake was giving away these sets or sending them instead of the dot cards that other companies send you, so you can just try the watercolors for yourself, that would be a great use for a set like this. But I would not recommend just buying this 12 color set and hoping you will have like a good sketching set or set to use outdoors or something. This also goes to my second problem that I have with this set, which is not about the watercolors themselves, about their quality, but the choice of colors that were featured in this set. You have two blues, two greens, two reds. With these pairs, the colors are really close to each other. So the blues, for example, that you got, the two colors, are kind of similar. So there's not much difference in the mixes that I tried to do with them. So even though this set should be more flexible because you have 12 colors, there's the white, there's the black, and you have two blues, two reds, and two greens that are similar to each other, and the mixes that you are doing with them are similar. So in the end, it feels more like a 7 set color than 12. These two things are a bit of a shame because I liked the quality of these paints. These seem to be really just good quality transparent watercolors that are fun to paint and to use together on a sketchbook with the felt tip fineliners that I received, and would be just fine for watercolor sketching, for example. And the set would be so much better if the box they came in and the color choice was a bit better. For the brush here, I used the watercolor brush from Kuretake. These are really flexible and come in few sizes, and you can also choose from a longer or shorter barrel. These are really useful and flexible tools. I used them for many, many years, even still when I was in Poland. So I know them very well and I like them. These are very easy to incorporate into your sketching set. Okay, this is how the picture turned out. I actually sketched two sides of this car because I liked it so much. It was great fun to do this sketch and I would like to do more, maybe a series of these. I certainly have enough photos of retro cars in my folder. Okay, that's it for this video. I hope you liked it. As always, feel free to comment, share and subscribe, and you can also support me on Patreon. It's your support there that allows me to spend time making these videos. I would also like to thank Kuretake for sending me all this gear to try. As a disclaimer, I got the watercolors that I used here free from Kuretake, but they didn't have any influence on the contents of this video. Okay, see you in the next one. Bye!